acceleration. Rate of change of velocity is called acceleration. Next, after finishing of that acceleration, what is uniform acceleration? And what is non-uniform acceleration? What is uniform acceleration and non-uniform acceleration? So, if changes in change in velocities, if change in velocities of a body are equal, if change in velocities of a body are equal in equal intervals of time, change in velocities of a body are equal in equal intervals of time, then body is said to be moving with uniform acceleration. If change in velocities of a body are equal in equal intervals of time, then body is said to be moving with uniform acceleration. What is the meaning of that? Change in velocities are equal in equal intervals of time, then that body is said to be moving with uniform acceleration. What is the meaning of this definition? See, a body is moving like this. A body is moving in this format. Now, here velocity of the body is 10 meter per second. After 1 second, its velocity becomes 20 meter per second. After 1 second, its velocity becomes 30 meter per second. After 1 second, it becomes 40 meter per second. So in equal time intervals, change in velocity should be, here in this time interval, what is the change in velocity? 20 minus 10, that will be 10 meter per second. In this time interval, change in velocity will be 30 minus 20, that will be 10 meter per second. Here what is the change in velocity? 40 minus 30, that is equal to 10 meter per second. So in equal intervals of time, change in velocities of a body are equal, then we can say that body is moving with uniform acceleration. If the point is clear, so another one will be what? Non-uniform acceleration. For this, what is the definition? If change in velocities of a body are unequal in equal intervals of time, then body is said to be moving with non-uniform acceleration. If changes in velocities of a body are unequal in equal intervals of time, then body is said to be moving with non-uniform acceleration. Like this, we will define the non-uniform acceleration. So here body is going like this. Here velocity 10 meter per second. After 1 second, velocity becomes 20 meter per second. After 1 second, velocity becomes 28 meter per second. After 1 second, velocity becomes 39 meter per second. Like this. In equal intervals of time, change in velocities are not equal. Here, what is the change in velocity? 10. Here, what is the change in velocity? 8 meter per second. Here, what is the change in velocity? 9 meter per second. 9? No. 11 meter per second. So, like this, change in velocities are unequal in equal intervals of time, then body is said to be moving with non-uniform acceleration. Next, after finishing of this, let us see what is meant by acceleration due to gravity. Acceleration due to gravity. It is indicated by the letter small g. The acceleration of a freely falling body is called acceleration due to gravity. We are taking one body. See this, take this chalk piece. We are dropping it in the air. We are dropping that chalk piece in the air. Then what will happen? When it is dropping in the air, gradually its velocity will increases. What you have to observe? Its velocity gradually increases. Here, its velocity is 0. U is equal to 0. Here, when it is falling down, what will happen? Its velocity will gradually increases. After 1 second, if the body came to here, after 1 second, its velocity will be 9.8 meter per second. In the next second, it came to here. Its velocity will be 19.6 meter per second. In the next second. In the next second, it came to here. This velocity will be 19.6 plus 9.9 or 9.8 into 3. This is 29.4 meter per second. So every 1 second, its velocity is increases by an amount of 9.8 meter per second. That is called acceleration due to gravity. The acceleration produced in a body due to Earth's gravitation, or the acceleration of a freely falling body, is called acceleration due to gravity. Try to understand. I dropped a body here. After 1 second, I measure its velocity. It came 9.8. After 1 second, I measured. It came 19.6. After 1 second, I measured. It came 29.4. After 1 second, if I measure, this 29.4 plus 9.8, so totally this is 39.2 meter per second. Every 1 second, velocity of the freely falling body is increasing by 1 second. That velocity is called, change in velocity is called acceleration due to gravity. So how we will define this C? Acceleration due to gravity. The acceleration of a freely falling body. The acceleration of a freely falling body is called acceleration due to gravity. Clear? Like this, we will define the acceleration due to gravity. Its value is 9.8 meter per second square. Okay, what is its value? Its average value actually 9.8 meter per second square. In some problems, while doing the problems, for easy calculation, instead of 9.8 they will give 10. For easy calculation they will give like that, but actually it is 9.8 meter per second square only. If they mentioned take g is equal to 10 meter per second square in the book, in that question they mentioned in bracket, then only you had to take g as 10 meter per second square. Otherwise, if they are not mentioned anything, means you have to take g as 9.8 meter per second square. Clear? Next, acceleration is a vector quantity. So acceleration due to gravity is also a vector quantity. Okay, next, for freely falling body, for freely falling body, A is equal to plus G, because it is moving towards the earth. We have to consider it as its acceleration is gradually increasing. So A is equal to plus G. For vertically projected body, vertically projected body means if this is the ground, from the ground I am projecting vertically like this, then if here this velocity is 30 meter per second, after 1 second what will happen? 30 minus 9.8, this becomes 20.2 meter per second. After 1 second, 20.2 minus 9.8, so how much we will get this one? 12.84. So 99 means 10.4. So 10.4 meter per second. Like this, if the body is going up, every 1 second its velocity decreases by an amount, 9.8 meter per second. For vertically projected body, A is equal to minus G. The point is clear. Vertically projected body, A is equal to minus G. Freely falling body, A is equal to plus G. Next, G value will remains constant at a given place. Means broadly overall the earth we have to consider. Place means small places like that, no need to consider. G value will be, if we consider this is the earth, this line will be called equator. These are called poles. This is Earth. At poles, G value will be slightly more. At equator, G value will be slightly less, 9.77 meter per second square. At poles, G value will be 9.83 meter per second square. Okay. At poles, G value will be maximum, and at equator, G value will be minimum. Average value, how much we will take? 9.8 meter per second square we will take. So at a given place in the entire Kolar district, maybe G value will be same only. If you go from one place to another place, there is a chance of small variations in G value. If you consider Kolar district, if you consider some more district, Gulbarga district, if you consider some Hubli district, then G value will slightly changes. But at a given place, G value will remains as the same. But from place to place, slight changes will be there. Next, where minerals are present in the earth, their G value will be more. Acceleration due to gravity will be more at that places. If Kolar gold fields is there, KGF is there, their mineral is there at that places, G value will be slightly more. Some of the old techniques to identify the location of the minerals in the earth, some 1800 at that time, people follow these techniques. Where G value is more, there is a chance of getting more minerals. The one chance. Like that, this is about acceleration due to gravity. The acceleration of a freely falling body is called acceleration due to gravity. Next, after finishing of this, let us see what are equations of motion. Equations of motion. U is the symbol for initial velocity. V is the symbol for final velocity. U is the symbol for initial velocity. V is the symbol for final velocity. A is called acceleration. T is time. S value will be displacement. Initial velocity, final velocity, acceleration, time, displacement. These are the symbols for these quantities. The relation among these quantities is given by equations of motion. The relation between initial velocity, final velocity, acceleration, time, displacement, all are given by this equations of motion. So how to write this? See, equations of motion. Equations of motion gives the relation between equations of motion gives the relation between initial velocity final velocity acceleration time and displacement. So equations of motion will give the relation between them. What are the equations of motion means? 1, v is equal to u plus at. 2, s is equal to ut plus half at square. V square minus u square is equal to 2as. Sn is equal to u plus a into n minus half. These are four equations of motion. V is equal to u plus at, s is equal to ut plus half at square, v square minus u square is equal to 2as, sn is equal to u plus a into n minus half. These four are considered as the equations of motion. The point is clear. Now, here terminology already you know. You don't know about Sn. Sn means displacement in the nth second. Displacement in the nth second is Sn. What is this S? Displacement in t seconds. That will be called S. Sn means displacement in nth second. Already these derivations for you, they came for you in the earlier classes. In the earlier classes, these definitions, these derivations are came. Here in the 11th standard level, we'll also derive this using graphical methods. How to derive this, we'll discuss that one in the coming class. Okay.